Greetings to all. This is Surbhi Jain, Assistant Professor, Sagar Institute of Research and Technology, Pharmacy, Bhopal. And today, my topic of discussion will be ICH, that is International Conference on Harmonization. And in this, we will discuss its introduction, organization, and what are the various guidelines issued by ICH. This is a subject from Quality Assurance, which is in the sixth semester. So as we move forward, we are start our lecture. That is, we will start from general introduction. What is ICH? It stands for International Conference on Harmonization. And in this, it is a project or it's a conference that brings together the regulatory authorities of Europe, Japan, and USA to discuss scientific and technical aspects of pharmaceutical product registration. So basically, ICH is a conference which is situated by three countries, by the contribution of three countries, that is Europe, Japan, and USA, to discuss various technical and scientific aspects for new drug product approval or registration. So in the coming slide, we will see its objective. What is the basic purpose of organizing or for establishing this guidelines? So for the harmonization of legislative and technical requirements, for the mutual acceptance of data between Europe, Japan, and USA, these are the three countries which is involved actively in this ICH. To reduce cost of research or work duplication, if the work is duplicated or if there is no certain guidelines which is allocated for the safety quality of the drug product, then unnecessary that cost of the research will be high or we will wasting the time. So that, because time frame is a very important and the critical step in the new drug development as it will reach to the market. So we have to maintain or formulate certain guidelines which will based on the quality, safety, and efficacy of the drug product for the customer as well as for the patient benefit. Now, what is the location of ICH? Means what is the, where is the headquarter of ICH situated? So it is basically situated in Geneva, Switzerland. And it's a committee. It consists of a committee which is named as ICH Steering Committee, which is established by Europe, European Union, Japan, and the USA. Now, who are the ICH members? So ICH consists of six parties that represent the regulatory bodies and research-based industry in Europe, Japan, and USA. So as we all know that there is a regulatory authority for each country. As we know, for India, CDSCO. Same alike in Japan, the members which is in the ICH is the from the MHLW, that is Ministry of Health, Labor and Welfare, JPMA, Japan Pharmaceutical Manufacturer Association. Here you will notice one thing, that the committee is organized from the regulatory body member or one member from research-based industry, so that the regulatory body will give the approval and the research-based industry gives the knowledge about the quality control or quality safety data of the drug product. Same in the case of Europe, the members include European Union, that is EU, European Federation of Pharmaceutical Industries and Association, EFPIA. So this is an active member from Europe in the ICH committee. Then in the USA, the members include Food and Drug Administration, as we all know that USFDA, or Pharmaceutical Research and Manufacturer of America. And the additional members in this ICH includes observers from WHO, the World Health Organization, European Free Trade Association, and Canada. So these are the additional members who is involved actively in ICH. Now ICH organization. ICH structure consists of ICH Steering Committee, ICH Coordinator, ICH Secretariat, and ICH Working Group. So these are the four basic classification for the organizational structure of ICH. Now, what is the function of ICH Steering Committee? What they will do? So, functions of this body include, if they will govern the whole ICH, they determine the policies and procedures for ICH, they will select which are the topic of harmonization. Harmonization means a fixation of any guidelines which will be followed worldwide or universally. Monitor progress of harmonization initiatives. So these are the various important functions of ICH Steering Committee, why they are established and what they will work for. Then ICH coordinator. Now the function of coordinator is for smooth functioning of ICH. Coordinators are nominated by each of these six parties, as which we have mentioned earlier. It acts as a main contact point with ICH Secretariat. So the coordinator and the secretariat are in direct contact with each other, and they will perform their activities for the smooth conduction of the organization. Then ICH Secretariat. Now, what are the functions? They prepare for documentation of meetings of a steering committee. They coordinate preparation for working groups and discussion group meetings. The following information can be obtained from ICH Secretariat: that ICH guidelines, what are the guidelines, and what are the general ICH process. So they overall responsible for the documentation and for the coordination of the various meetings and the working groups. Now, ICH working groups. So there are basically three type of working groups which will be established by ICH: expert working group, implementation working group, and informal working group. So these are the three working groups under the organizational structure of ICH. Now, ICH operation. So ICH operation, it operates through steering committee, as we have discussed, with administrative support from secretariat and coordinators. Steering committee meets at least twice a year, and during above, the following measures are adopted. They will discuss on the new topics for adoption. They will review the existing topic progress report, and they will discuss the maintenance and implementation of guidelines. So jo meeting hoti hai, that is twice a year jo meeting conduct hoti hai, they will do the discussion on the new topic ki abhi kis topic pe hume certain discussion karna hai. They will also review jo existing topics ki unka progress kya hai, and they will also discuss the maintenance and implementation of guidelines, which is very important. So these are the functions for the ICH operation. Now, ICH guidelines topics. So unke jo basically topics hote hain discussion ki, wo kis cheez pe based hote hain. So that is based on quality, efficacy, safety, and multidisciplinary. That is QESM. So Q stands for quality, which means which will satisfy the customer need, or we can say the degree of excellence. What is efficacy? Efficacy we can define as effectiveness of the drug. How much it is effective. Safety means it should be safe for the patient and from the consumer point of view. And multidisciplinary, it includes the cross-cutting topics. So quality, it refers to the topics related to chemical and pharmaceutical quality assurance. Example, they include the guidelines which stands for stability testing and impurity testing. Efficacy refers to the topic that deals with clinical studies in human subjects, that includes dose response studies and GCP, that is good clinical practices. Safety, they refers to the topic that deals with in vitro and in vivo preclinical studies, for example, carcinogenicity testing and genotoxicity testing, because these are very important. If the patient or the consumer will take our drug, then it should be free from any impurities. It should not affect the genetic makeup of the individual, or it should not be carcinogenic or cancerous for the patient. Multidisciplinary, these refer to the topics that do not fit uniquely into any of the above categories. तो ये इसमें वो सारे टॉपिक्स आते हैं जो QSE में फिट नहीं होते हैं. सो देयर इज अ सर्टेन एक सेपरेट इन्होंने गाइडलाइन बनाई जिसे कहते हैं मल्टीडिसिप्लिनरी, एंड इट इज आल्सो नोन एज क्रॉस कटिंग टॉपिक्स. सो क्वालिटी गाइडलाइन में हमारी Q1A से लेके Q1F तक आती है, Q2, Q3, Q4, Q5, Q6 अप टू Q8. सो द डिटेल्ड डिस्क्रिप्शन ऑफ द गाइडलाइंस वी विल सी इन द नेक्स्ट लेक्चर. So these are just the classification of quality guidelines. Safety guideline में आती है हमारी S1 से S9 के बीच में, and it mainly deals with, as I have told you, it mainly deals with in vivo and in vitro preclinical studies. Efficacy, they refers to the topic that deals with clinical studies. Example, dose response studies and good clinical practices. Multidisciplinary includes M1, that is MedDRA terminology. ESTRI, electronic standard for transmission of regulatory information. Guidance on non-clinical safety data and the common technical document, that is CTD. So these are the references. Thank you for listening to the class. Thank you.